What stands out most about Tears of the Black Tiger is how director Wisit Sasanatieng made the film for audiences all across the globe. For this video essay, I'm going to be talking about Wisit's use of the Eastern Western genre to platform his films for a global audience. Oh, by the way, this is Wisit Sasanatieng. He's known for this. Oh, and all of those too. But today, we're going to be taking a look at this. Let's start by figuring out what a Western is. Typically, a Western is a film comprised of a strong independent main character, typically exceptional at their craft. This character is somewhat flawed, but ultimately shows a glimmer of humanity with a deeper sense of good despite their internal struggles. They do all this while accentuating American values and cultural traditions, such as America's strong gun culture. If we accept this definition of a Western, we can then say that an Eastern Western is when a filmmaker from an Eastern country adopts the structures and conventions while building off this framework to make it marketable to an Eastern or global audience. The genre has a simple framework and is often looked down upon by a lot of popular cinema, but it's the simplicity of the genre that perhaps makes it one of the most unique. Let me explain. These genres excel due to the moral complexity of these characters, in part because it mirrors our own. Just like us, they are all learning and growing as they're moving through the path of life. Their shortcomings make us think of our shortcomings. Perhaps the reason we root for them is the reflection of ourselves rooting for us on our own journey. So, is that it? Yes. But no. Anyone, regardless if you're born in Asia, Africa, or the United States, can relate to these characters. The genre allows the director to give us a reflection of ourselves, where we get to be the badass saving the town. It is the simplicity of this framework that allows directors to market these films to a global audience, and Wisit is a great example of this. Here, let me show you. Throughout the film, we follow Dumb. We see the murdering of his family, which is ultimately what leads him to fall in with the bandits. While many of us cannot relate to being in a gang of bandits, we can all relate to what it feels like to go through hardships and be in unforgiving circumstances. We all have an understanding of how these circumstances could affect someone at a young age, making his shortcomings not all that unreasonable. This can be seen as a flaw in Dumb's character, which helps the audience member understand and relate to his character. Once again, we see our shortcomings in Dumb's shortcomings, making us root for him in his journey, the same way we're rooting for our own. So, we know how Wisit demonstrates Dumb's flaws, but how does he show that Dumb is exceptional at what he does? Well, to start, in this gunslinging scene with Mahiswan, Wisit utilizes quick cuts and close-up shots to help reinforce the speed at which Dumb can gunsling. Here, Dumb not only shoots the snake about to attack Mahiswan, but also the tree branch it was on so it would fall on Mahiswan's head. This once again reinforces that deeper sense of good I was talking about earlier, but it also shows how exceptional he is with his gun. Throughout life, we often admire those who excel at what they do, and this applies to cinema as well, helping us root for Dumb just a little more. The scene is also a great example of how Wisit takes opportune moments like these to market to a transnational audience. Despite the film being made in Thailand, he uses a classical trope of what is known as the standoff from Western films. You've seen it here, 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 and, well, here. This, along with the film's abundant use of guns, playing into America's gun culture, demonstrates Wisit's understanding of how Eastern Westerns could fulfill a transnational demand for these types of films. Willis said it best in his critical analysis of the film, stating that, quote, "This Thai-bred storyline is covered up in a Hollywood fit case of action so that it appeases all. the ones who love the so-called great nostalgic story in the trigger-happy section of Hollywood. Okay, so we understand Dumb's shortcomings, and we also understand that Dumb is exceptional at what he does. But how does Wisit show his deeper sense of good? Take a look at this scene. When Dumb's gang of bandits capture police captain Kumjorn, the leader of the gang demands that Dumb execute the police captain. Dumb received a direct order from his leader and has every reason to execute the police captain. Dumb goes into the room and puts his gun to the captain's head. The captain essentially says, "If I ask a final favor, will you do it?" Dumb replies, "If I can, I will." The captain then informs Dumb that he is engaged and to let his fiance know of his fate. He then pulls out a photo of Rampui, a girl Dumb has grown up with and come to fall in love with. Then in the next scene, we see that Dumb has allowed the captain to escape. This could be for a multitude of reasons. Also, real quick, in case you haven't seen the movie for yourself, Dumb stabs himself to make the escape believable. Just thought you should know that. Alright, back to the video. One is that Dumb feels sympathy towards the captain and wants to give him the opportunity to get married. Or perhaps he feels sympathetic for Rampui and doesn't want to be the reason her soon-to-be husband is dead. Let us assume for a moment that Dumb was inherently bad. Perhaps he would not care and go through with execution fulfilling his leader's orders, or even go through with the execution in hopes to have a chance with Rampui now that she would be single. For whatever reason, Dumb made the ethical choice to allow the captain to leave, demonstrating to the audience a glimmer of humanity in his character. This demonstration of a deeper sense of what's morally right allows the audience to root for Dumb, despite the fact that he's abandoned. This moral complexity is a key component for hooking the audience in. It's something universal, allowing anyone and everyone to relate to Dumb and his journey, regardless of their nationality. The transnationality of Eastern Westerns is undebatable, and Tears of the Black Tiger clearly demonstrate the global demand and supply for Eastern Westerns. It's an opportunity for directors all across the globe to get their films seen by more eyes than one could imagine. Eastern Westerns are not just a fun subgenre you can watch with your family. It is a genre of film that innovates and redefines filmmaking as we know it, despite its simple framework.